First of all, I'd like to say hello to all of my many friends, also to my many enemies. Once again, this is your friend, brother, and humble servant, Roosevelt, coming back at you with another episode of Roosevelt Sounds Off. I'd like to thank everyone for tuning into the program on today. And if you're not yet a subscriber to Roosevelt Sounds Off, go down and hit the subscribe button along with the bell icon. This way you'll be notified anytime I drop a brand new video right here on YouTube. Okay, gonna get right into what I want to talk about on this morning, this afternoon, this evening, whenever you happen to be watching, because this is a late Tuesday evening here in Chicago. But you know, I had a little bit of news to report on, not mine, but you all's favorite sister girl, and that is Kamala Harris, or should I say Vice President Kamala Harris. Now, many of you all know where I stand when it comes down to the Biden administration and along with Vice President Kamala Harris. How I feel that, you know, the Biden administration and Kamala Harris have done nothing but just enable white supremacy through unjust laws like the three strikes you're out law and the 94 crime bill which Joe Biden wrote, along with Kamala Harris, who imprisoned a lot of black people during the time that she was Attorney General of California. But many of you all out there, especially a whole lot of you over-emotional, stupid black people, or should I say, all of you Biden sexuals and Kamala Harris hoes, chose to vote for her anyway, not even studying and knowing her history. But I have something new that just came out concerning Kamala Harris, and that is talking about the family of the late Nina Simone. As if you all very well know, Nina Simone was a famous jazz singer who pretty much was a revolutionary, you know, for her time. She even made a song back in the day called I'm Feeling Good, and another one entitled Mississippi Goddamn. It, you know, known for many other things, and she passed away around 2003. And her estate was left with her daughter. But what does Kamala Harris do? Kamala Harris steps in and takes over the estate of Nina Simone, snatching it away from her family and giving it to what, you all? White people. The reason why this came down to light is because the granddaughter of the late Nina Simone, which is Rihanna Simone Kelly, spoke out about this in a tweet around last Thursday, last Friday, talking about what Kamala Harris has done to separate and destroy their family. I'm about to play you this video clip, and this is compliments of another YouTube video, and they can break this thing down and explain it a little bit better than me, but you all will see exactly what I am talking about and why, after hearing this, hopefully your hatred for Kamala Harris will grow greater and stronger, just like mine. So I'm going to play you this clip, and afterwards I'm going to come right back and tell you exactly what I think. And you all know me, that I am Roosevelt, and I will not hold back. Please stay tuned for this clip.
Nina Simone's granddaughter has accused Kamala Harris of taking the legendary singer's estate away from her family and giving it to white people while she served as California's Attorney General. Rihanna Simone Kelly made the inflammatory claim on Twitter Friday, sharing a scathing string of tweets about the now vice president. Nina's granddaughter here. My family doesn't run her estate anymore. It was taken away from us and given to white people. Our family name was dragged in the media. We get no royalties, nothing. Wanna hold someone accountable? Ask Kamala Harris why she came for my family, Rihanna raged. After Nina Simone's death in 2003, her daughter Lisa Simone Kelly was made the administrator of both her estate and a charitable trust. The trust was set up for the musical education of black African children from South Africa, Liberia, and Ghana. However, in 2013, Lisa was accused of breaching her fiduciary duty to both the estate and trust, allegedly draining up to $2 million from its coffers, including a $1.5 million deposit into her personal company, the Daily Beast reports. Kamala Harris, who was serving as California's AG at the time, oversaw the case and decided that Kelly was in the wrong. Harris initially sought to collect a surcharge of $5.93 million plus over $2.5 million in interest from Lisa. However, the state of California and Kelly later came to a separate agreement. As part of the settlement terms, Lisa was stripped of her title of estate administrator and agreed to relinquish her rights to Simone's works. But Lisa is said to have been devastated by that deal. Rihanna Simone Kelly, Lisa's daughter, wrote on Twitter that it caused her mom to become suicidal. As I said before, ask her, Harris, why she separated my family. Ask her why my grandmother's estate is in shambles now. Ask her why we as her family no longer own the rights to anything. Ask her why she bullied my mother in court and my mom almost killed herself from the depression. Rihanna added, my grandmother is influencing the masses, as she should. I see her on billboards. I see artists covering her music. It breaks my heart to know that white people are making money off of grandma's hard work and that we have had all of our rights as her family stripped from us. Meanwhile, she pointed out that John Legend performed a cover of a Nina Simone song during a Biden-Harris inauguration concert earlier this year. While we're asking Kamala questions, ask her why after all of this pain and suffering she put us through a Nina Simone song was sang at the inauguration to swear her in as VP? She knew what she was doing, Rihanna stated.
Okay, and we are back, and that clip falls under the category of fair use. So you all, let's get ready to go in. Now, you heard what that brief video clip has said. How she took over the estate of Nina Simone during the time that she was Attorney General, stripped it away from her family, and gave it to white people. And I'm just wondering, how in the heck can she do something like this? Because as far as I'm concerned, when Nina Simone made whatever money that she made, singing and entertaining, I mean, she made that money for them and their family. Now, of course, they says that, you know, the daughter misused a couple of things and took some money out of the account and put it in her personal bank account, but that's still their family's money. How can the Attorney General of California take this thing over and then did not want her daughter talking about this, so she put a gag order on her daughter. So much so to the point that Nina Simone's family can no longer say that they're associated with Nina Simone. They can't even talk about it. But the granddaughter, this generation, is talking about it. So what is it that you know about someone like Kamala Harris? She's a dirty, rotten, low-down snake. That's what Kamala Harris is. Someone who a whole lot of you black people decided to vote for. Some of you all were hoping that she would even be able to be president. Some of you all are still hoping that she can be able to be president. But yet, we're talking about the same person who helped to send a lot of black people to jail, held back evidence in people's cases and people's trials that she knew were innocent, but held back discovery in their case just to keep them in prison longer. But hey, what can I say? That's the sister girl. This is y'all's sister girl. Not me. You notice I didn't say my sister girl. I said you all sister girl. Not mine. Mm-mm. Never will be. Never can be. because it's someone who wouldn't have any loyalty to me at all. This is what she did. And plus, the policies of the Biden and Harris administration are still devastating people now. How she showed up in Venezuela and they had out signs protesting her visit, telling her, Vice President Kamala, go home. No. And we as the black community need to be telling her to go home. And so many of you people, so many people who I personally know and talk to, people who know me personally, you know, always want to say, well, you know, Biden ain't so bad because, you know, because at least by Biden, you know, so many of you ignorant, stupid, you know, cooning, handkerchief-headed, stupid, ignorant, low-rent black people talking about, you know, Biden, at least you're a Democrat, and, you know, a Democrat, you know, they ain't like the Republicans, you know, at least you can get something out of them, and even if you can't get nothing out of them, he might be a white man, you know, getting that true enough, yeah, you know, Biden, he a white man and everything, oh, yeah, he a white man, he got that black woman running alongside of him who gonna straighten him out, and even though we know that the Democrats or the Republicans ain't done anything for us, and I'm saying this, you all, there's no black agenda on the table, there's no reparations on the table, there's no punishment for police or anything on the table, nothing on the table. Right now they're doing everything for immigrants and doing every single thing to help Asians, and with this missionary zeal to try to stop COVID, and doing a whole lot of other stuff, and passing more executive orders than he ever passed. Well, any other president has ever passed in history, but nothing on the table for black people. But so what? You all, you know, younger people gotta stop complaining. Because you know, don't worry, he's gonna do something for us. He gonna do something for us. Just know Biden will. He wouldn't be in office because if it wasn't for black people, he gonna do something for us. The idiot's not gonna do anything. Stupid, ignorant niggas keep on thinking that Biden or Harris is going to do something for them. And no, just because there's a black woman in, or so-called, should we say, black woman in the office of the vice presidency, does not mean that they're going to do anything. Just because they put a black face in front of us doesn't mean that they're any good. Obama was in office for 2 terms, 8 years straight, and did absolutely, positively nothing for black people. What can I say? This is y'all sister girl. This is sister girl. But how is that working for you? It didn't work out for the family of Nina Simone. You see what they said in the clip? How she bullied her? Kamala Harris bullied her mother so much in court that her mother fell into about a depression and almost committed suicide. How many people that, you know, whose lives were ruined by Kamala Harris? A whole lot of black people in Oakland and in San Francisco cannot stand her. And I just bet you, Joe Biden didn't probably even want her in there as vice president. The only reason why he picked her as vice president is because, some of y'all don't know this either, Obama was running his campaign, and he's the one who instructed him to put her in that place. Or maybe it was like this. Maybe, you know, since, you know, her first job was, you know, she slept her way to the top, you all, with Lowdown Willie Brown, the old mayor of San Francisco. You know, maybe she got down on her knees and, you know, licked some balls and sucked a couple of dicks in order to get into office or become anointed as vice president. Well, we just don't know. But it wasn't something that was honest, and it was not something that was fair and square. Look at what she is doing now. Destroyed this family. And there's many others out there who are just nameless. Especially, you know, you're a prosecutor and you have held back evidence in people's cases, people who you knew were innocent, and a whole lot of people who were in prison were serving on the fire brigade in charge of putting out those wildfires in California. She held back evidence in their cases to keep them in jail longer so they could serve on the fire brigade to keep putting out fires in the California desert, in the mountains, just to keep some rich person's home from, or mansion, should I say, from burning down. That's what she did it for. So someone who caters to white supremacy. And you all think that she is something, all because she's a so-called black woman, when she at first did not even run on the premise, when she ran for senator of California as a black woman, she ran as an Asian, told people that she was South Asian. She was not black. The only reason why she threw black in there at this last minute when she was running for the presidency is because she knows, even she's smart enough to know, that even though black people are only 12 or 13% of the American population, we carry a big voting block here within this country. So she decided just to come over and, you know, come over to this side, I guess. And then a whole lot of you all believe the lies she wanted to tell about, you know, I smoked weed and danced along to the music of Tupac and Biggie Smalls. You know, a whole lot of y'all believe that lie. And another lie that she told, when she told the lie about Kwanzaa, talking about her favorite principle of Kwanzaa was Kukuchakalia. And, you know, when I grew up and everything, the elders of the family, you know, all, you know, came together during the celebration of Kwanzaa. But wait a minute, miss. I'm going to tell you where the lie comes in. Because she was not raised with the black side of her family. She was only raised with the East Indian Asian side of her family. So where is this whole thing come in with the celebration of Kwanzaa when she was not raised even on the black side of the family, only the East Indian side? This is why she might have joined a black church later on in life, but originally she was raised Hindu, which is the major majority religion of most people who live in India and Nepal. See, you know, whenever these people say something, you gotta look for the lie. That's what I urge everybody to do. Look for the lie, because there's plenty there. So I'm just sorry that, you know, this family was almost destroyed. The family of Nina Simone was almost destroyed by certain things Kamala Harris has done and still is doing. But what discourages me and makes me even more angry is to how a whole lot of you black people are still running up behind her and still thinking that she is going to do something good, her and Biden, that they're still going to do something good for black people when they haven't done anything yet. There's no black agenda on the table. The cavalry's not coming, you all. You know, they could help Asians. They could help LGBT rights. They could, you know, help abortion laws. They could try to help immigrants, everybody but us. They haven't even done something as simple as pass the George Floyd Policing Act. But yet, you know, Biden could sign it into effect that Juneteenth is a national holiday, something that hardly don't even count to where the survival of black people is concerned. And look at what Kamala Harris has done to another so-called black family. So it just goes to show you, she's not black because she has no loyalty to you or to me at all. So we need to stop supporting these wicked, evil politicians that have no loyalty to any one of us. That's my challenge to you today. So with all of that being said, I'm gonna get off this subject. And if anybody liked this video, please do me a favor. Give me a thumbs up. I greatly appreciate it. And please tune in next time for another episode of Roosevelt Sounds Off. And until the next video, this has been your friend, brother, and humble servant Roosevelt, saying peace and blessings to all of you and your families.